Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Money Osai. Today we are going to see some unknown interesting information on Indian coins, like where the coins are minted and what was the value of coins at the time of independence and before independence, and some more interesting facts to be noted. Let's go into the video. History of Indian coins dates back to 6th century BC. India stood first in trading commodities using coins. Next to India is China, which took the second place using the coins for trading. India got the word rupiah from the Sanskrit word which means casting silver coin, that is, they melt silver and make it into coins, and which were used for circulation. As per archaeology report, we got many coins of Mauryan dynasty, among which Chandragupta Maurya I made coins using gold, silver, copper and lead. Then came the period of Seshasuri, who minted coin named rupiah, which weighed 11.66 grams. After him, British East Indian Company came to rule in 18th century, that is 1835. They minted many coins, and even currencies were minted and circulated during their time. In olden days, we were using cowries and also coins for circulation. This is the broken cowrie, that is putti cowrie. 3 putti cowrie is equal to 1 full cowrie. If you take 10 full cowries, which is equal to 1 damari. 1 damari value is equal to 3/4 pi. If you have 2 damari, which is equal to 1 della. And 2 della is equal to 1 paise. In 1935, RBI was started, which took in charge for dealing with coins and currencies. Even after independence, in 1947, India used British East Indian Company's coins for 3 years, that is from 1947 to 1950. Even after that, our independence time, from 1947 to 1957, for 10 years, we were using Anna's value for transaction. If you see, we have minted coins with bronze, copper and nickel mixed coins, and copper coins and purely nickel coins for transaction. 1 rupee coin is equal to 16 annas, and 1 anna is equal to 4 paise. Anna is the value used by British for measuring the value of commodities in those days. So in 1957, due to decimalization, 1 rupee value is equal to 16 annas was banned. Then we used 100 paise is equal to 1 rupee. So this was continued from then. In those days, we used the word naya paise because it was a new scheme. Naya means new in Hindi. So which in later days, we removed naya and we used paise only. In 1960, due to economic crisis and inflationary trend, India started to mint coins in aluminium. In 1970, 1 paise, 2 paise, 3 paise coins was chopped, and it was replaced by issuing 10 paise, 20 paise, 25 paise and even 50 paise. In 1988, new coin was minted and issued. Thus, as per the government rule, they minted and circulated coins for people needs and necessaries. Coins were first minted in Bombay, but the minted coins were not enough for trading purposes. Government has to start some more industries to mint coins. So they have decided to start new minting industries in floor places, namely Mumbai, Noida, Kolkata and Hyderabad. In this, the coin If you see the coins, below the rupee, if you have a year and a small inscription. If you have a round shape inscription, you find it is minted in Noida. If you have a diamond shaped inscription below the value, it is minted in Mumbai. If you find any star shaped inscription, then it is printed in Hyderabad. If you don't find any inscription at all below the year, then it has been minted in Kolkata. In 2007, coins were suddenly of shortages. We were not able to get coins for regular trading activities. The shopkeeper find very difficult to use the coins for circulation because of its shortages. They got the coins from beggars. The beggars turned into businessmen. They sold their coins in street for currency notes. They charge 100 coins for 120 rupees or more. When government analyzed the reason for this coin issues, they came to know that bulk coins were transported to Bangladesh, where they melted the coins and converted them into razor blades, fountain pen nibs, and ornaments made out of nickels. And even sculptures were made using these coins. By melting 1 rupee coins, they were able to make nearly 5 to 7 razor blades. Do you know 1 rupee coin value is really 35 rupees worthful? So, government took proper steps to overcome this. RBI have started to mint some coins named as commemorative coins. These commemorative coins have been minted in order to have a particular issues. In 2010, due to celebration of RBI Platinum Jubilee, they issued a 75 rupees coin for circulation. 150th Rabindranath Tagore's birthday, to celebrate this occasion, 150 rupees coins has been minted and issued. 1000 years completion of Tanjore Bahadeeshwarar temple has been celebrated in 2012 by minting 1000 rupees coin. As per the nominations of 2011 RBI Act, RBI has power to print coins up to 1000 rupees only. Thank you.